Good morning, grade 2. Today we are going to start the revision for chapter 10 and the chapter 11. So I want from you all to open up your science book in page 303. Okay, let's go. As you can see here, grade 2, from this picture, this girl, she is in motion. Why, teacher? She is in motion because she changed her place from one to another. She moved from point A to point B. That's why we can say she is in motion. So motion means motion is the act of moving. Objects, grade 2, can move in different ways. As you know, they can move in a straight line, in zigzag lines. They can move in a circle. And I think you remember when we did it in a class, right? So again, motion is the act of moving. The act of moving. We can say about something or someone, he is in motion when he changes his place from one to another and when he moves from point A to point B. So turning the page, grade 2. Yes, it's a force. We can say that, as you can see here, force mean is to grate, pull or push. Pull or push, grade 2, means force. When you are trying to pull something or you push something, you did or you applied force. And as you know too, we need to apply more force to move heavier objects more than lighter one, right? So push or pull, meaning of force. Okay? Okay, teacher. Another meaning or another picture for push and pull. Okay, push and pull means force. Done. Turn the page. I think you figured out what I'm trying to say from this picture. It's this man, he was sitting, suddenly an apple fall down in his head. He discovered why, because of something pull everything towards the ground. There is something pull everything toward the ground. This thing great to we name it gravity. Excellent, great. So this gravity, here we are, gravity pulls everything towards the ground. Okay, so this is the meaning of gravity. That's why grade 2, we did not fall down. Even as you know that the earth go around itself, why we did not fall down? Because of the gravity, it pulls everything towards the ground. Again, another one, this man is trying to fall, to throw this apple, to throw this bowl up, but it did not fall, it did not go up, it fall down. Why? Because of the gravity. Great. Here we are. Yes, it's the work. As you can see here, grade 2, this in the first case, this woman here, she applied, excellent, she applied work. Why, teacher, you said she did work? Because the box moved. If the box did not move, sorry, you did not apply work. Like if I asked you now to try to push the wall, you did not do work. But push this basket, of course, you did work. But why? Because it moved. Because it moved. So grade 2, work happens whenever a force make an object move. Okay, if it moved, you applied work. If it didn't move, you did not apply work. Okay, and again, we need to apply more work for the heavier objects more than the lighter ones. Okay, grade 2, done. Great, let's go. Yep, here we are. It's a friction force, or the force of friction. As you can see here, it's in the opposite side of motion. I know, you know, it's great too. Great. So, friction force, great too. It's in the opposite side of the motion. Okay, why, teacher? Because friction force slow down your motion. Slow down your motion. So, again, rubbing hands, it's a friction force that make your hands warm. Okay, and for the last time, friction force, it's in the opposite side of motion. Great. This, yeah, I think you know it and you like this lesson so much. It's about the sample machines. simple machine. They are so wonderful tools that help us to make our work faster and easier. And here we have some of them. Pulley. Pulley. We use the pulley to move an object up and down, right? Wedge. Wedge, like a knife. We can use the wedge to cut things to parts. Screw. Screw, it helps us to hold things together. Great. Inclined plane. Inclined plane, great too. As you know, it's a flat, okay? It has two sides, one of them a flat. It also helps us to make our work easier and faster. Wheel and axle. Wheel and axle. Wheel and axle, I think most of you watched it before. Wheel and axle can help you to move things, right? Great. Then we still have a lever, right? This lever is a simple machine. It's used also to move things, right? So I can say, teacher, about all of this simple machine, we can use it to make our work easier and faster. And as you know too, that this there are some animals, right? Their body parts makes like a simple machine. That's true. Like what? Like rabbit. Rabbit great too, as you know, it uses claws as a wedge, right? To dig in the ground, great. A badger, claws also use it as a wedge. Excellent, great too. The bird beak can use its beak great too as a beaver, the liver, right? To carry food, great. A beaver, beaver use its teeth, great. To do what? As a wedge to cut or to carry to food, right? Great, great too. So, simple machine. It makes our work easier and faster. Great. Yes, let's come to the last lesson in this chapter. Chapter 10, lesson 5. What are magnets? As you can see here, this is the magnet. It has two poles. N and S. N means north. S means south. Okay? This magnet can attract only metals. Can attract only metals. All the metal, teacher? Actually, great too. Nope, not all the metal, but we can say it attracts what? Iron? Great. So here we are. Yes. Attract and repel. The same poles, great to they repel. Repel means push away or go away from me, okay? This is the meaning of repel. As you can see here, S and S, N, N and N. So the same poles repel. N and N repel, S and S repel, but the opposite poles, they attract. As you can, they love each other. Come to me. As you can see here in the first case, N and S, they attract. So like poles, the same poles, they hate each other. They say, stay away from me, go away from me, I don't like you. The meaning of repel. Okay, great too. What the magnet can attract? The magnet can attract what? Iron or metals. Okay, and copper too, teacher. Yeah, that's right. But what about the penny? Can you remember the penny? Nope, teacher. Why? Because it's made of copper, right? So copper, it's not attracted to the magnet. Okay, done? Great. Let's go. We are now in chapter 11, lesson 1. Okay, it's about the sound. Okay, what is sound? Can you see here, great too? Yep, sound is made great too when an object vibrates. And all of you know what I mean by vibrate. Vibrate means to move forth and back quickly. So the same question again, as you can see here, this guitar, violin, they can make a sound, right? Okay, because when they vibrate means move forth and back quickly. Okay, yep. And we use the two words great to describe this sound. One of them is loudness, and the other one is pitch. First one, loudness means how loud or soft sound is. How loud or soft sound is. Okay, this is the meaning of loudness, because great two, not all the sounds are soft sounds and not all the sounds are loud sounds. I want from you to look at this picture here and circle or just tell me the soft sounds and the loud sounds, okay? Look at the sound of the butterfly. I'm trying to tell you some examples, okay? Not all of them, of course. Sound of the butterfly, sound of the mouse, sound of the bee, all of them, I think it's soft sounds, okay? But what about the sound of the train, sound of the trucks, right? They are loud sounds. So if we are trying to describe a sound, not all the sounds are soft, not all the sounds are loud. So loud or soft means loudness. Let's come to the other word, word grade two, like I told you, it's a pitch. Pitch means how high or low sound is. How high or low sound is. As you can see here, sound of the birds, they are high pitch. Sound of the frog, it's low pitch. Teacher, I think grade two, you need more examples here. So again, sound of the bird, it's high pitch. Sound of the frog, it's low pitch. And let's go for more examples. If we have four bottles of three bottles here, okay, I want for you to look at your book, page 338, 339, okay? These four bottles, okay? The bottles with lots of air, grade two, make a sound with the low pitch. Bottles with less air make a sound with a higher pitch, okay? So it's verse or VS, okay? Done? Okay, let's go. Sound can travel, teacher. That's right. Sound travel faster through solid, liquid, and gases. So which one, teacher? The sound travel fastest one? Through solids, then through liquid, then through gases. So again, which one the sound can travel the fastest one? It's a solid, then liquid, then gases. That's why, teacher, we can hear sounds everywhere. That's why, grade two, we can hear the sounds everywhere, because the sound travel. Great. Here we are. As you can see here, if the sound did not travel, of course, we will not hear anything. Okay? Here, sound travel at the waves through the air. The air is the slowest one. As you can see here, also some animals, how they make a sound, and we said about this before. As an example here, it's the rattlesnake. The rattlesnake has a rattle at the end of its tail. It uses it to make a sound. Okay, the rattlesnake make a sound like a maracas. Okay, spiny lobster, grade two, make a sound like a violin. Okay, so done. Okay. Sounds all around. That's a true, teacher. Sounds are everywhere. Sound of crying babies, sound of laughing babies. Okay, we can hear the sound on the street, sirens beep and honks, sound of your mommy, daddy, TV. So sounds are everywhere. We can hear the sounds everywhere. Grade two, why? Because the sound travel. Okay, thank you, grade two, so much for watching. See you inshallah. Bye.